Hi everyone, welcome to the Apoby Resonance Chemistry. Now I'll continue my lectures on biomolecules. In previous case, we will discuss the amino acids, I think lecture number 127, that is part 7. Okay, now in this session, we will start the second part of the second part of the biomolecules, that is nothing but carbohydrates. In this session, we will discuss the many of the lectures, these carbohydrate topics. So this is very important topic for the CSIR NET, GATE, JOM students to IIT JEE mains, NEET, MCET students also. Okay, so let us follow these carbohydrate lectures, then you will get the definite marks from the each and every competitive exams of the chemistry. Okay, now in this session, we will start the basic introduction of the carbohydrates as well as the classification of the carbohydrates. Okay, now we'll go through the carbohydrates. So the according to the carbohydrates, a general old definition, so they are hydrates of carbon atoms. So many of the scientists, they are blindly believed that, so this is the original definition of the carbohydrates. So this is the hydrates of carbon atom. So according to the definition, they are given the a formula that is nothing but CXH2OY. So this is the hydrates of the carbon atoms. It is called carbohydrates. So this is the old definition. According to them, they are satisfied some of the carbohydrates molecules glucose and fructose. Okay, so these two compounds having the C6H12O6 formula. So this is can be written as C6H2O6 times. Here 12 hydrogen atoms, 6 oxygen atoms. So it satisfies that. As well as sucrose moiety. So sucrose is nothing but C12H22O11. So which is also can be written as H2O 11 times. So these compounds will show the hydrates of carbon, hydrates of the carbon atom definition. Okay. So however, some of the carbohydrates might is ramanose as well as deoxyribose, they cannot satisfy these rules even though they are the carbohydrates. So the now molecular formula C6H12O5, here C5H10O4. So these two are the compounds. Here these two compounds do not follow our hydrates of carbon atoms, hydrates of carbon atom definition. So even though these two are the carbohydrate, however, some of the compounds, some of the carbohydrates will follow the rule, some of the carbohydrates do not follow the rule. Okay, even though non-carbohydrate compounds can also obey these type of compounds. So let us examine ourselves. So here CH2O, C2H2O taken twice, C3H2O taken thrice. Okay, so this is the compound HC double bond OH, two hydrogen atoms, one carbon atom, one oxygen atom, that is nothing but formaldehyde. Okay, now here C2H2O taken twice, that is nothing but CH3COOH, which is nothing but acetic acid. Okay, now here C3H2O taken thrice, that is nothing but lactic acid. Okay, here CH3COOH is nothing but lactic acid. Okay, so these three compounds, organic acids and carbonyl compounds, here these are the organic compounds, but it obeys the carbohydrate rule. So that's why these world definition are question mark. Okay, so whether it is correct or not, so that's why here it requires the modification of the our definition. That's why we will go through the a modified definition of the carbohydrates. Why? Because here some of the carbohydrates will follow that, some of the compounds will do not follow the our old definition, but non-other carbohydrates can also follow the our definition. That's why here it requires modification. Now we'll go through the modification of the carbohydrate definition. Modified definition is nothing but here it is the optically active compounds as well as here it is the polyhydroxycarbonyl compounds. We know that carbonyl compounds, here two types of carbonyl compounds are there. One is aldehyde, another one is ketone. Okay, one is aldehyde and another one is ketone. Okay, again, the compounds, the carbohydrates, they can broken into further compounds. They can be broken into polyhydroxyaldehydes or polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones. So now let us combine these three forms as our new modified definition. Optically active polyhydroxycarbonyl compounds, either aldehyde or ketone, they can easily broken into further polyhydroxyaldehydes and ketones. Then it is called carbohydrate. So the simple definition of the carbohydrates, polyhydroxy optically active carbonyl compounds or optically active polyhydroxycarbonyl compounds, either aldehyde or ketone, then it is called carbohydrate. Then it is called carbohydrate. This is the simplest definition regarding to the our carbohydrates. Okay. Now, however, so according to the, our definition, let us go through the simple example that is nothing but a very simple and a basic compound of the carbohydrate is the number of carbon atoms of the basic carbohydrates is 3. The minimum number of carbon atoms for the carbohydrate is 3. Now here 1, 2, 3. This is the simplest compound of the carbohydrate. That is nothing but a glyceraldehyde. Okay. So here glyceraldehyde is the simplest compound of the carbohydrate as well as a reference compound for the D and L configuration of the carbohydrate. We know that C12 mass is the reference compound for the molecular weight calculation of the anything and any material. Okay. Now here the D and L configuration reference compound is the glyceraldehyde. It is the direct question for the like lower level classes, lower level students. Now here the D and L configuration. We know that the two types of configurations are there. One is a relative configuration. And another one is absolute configuration. Absolute configuration. So the relative configuration is nothing but D and L. Absolute configuration is nothing but R and S configurations. R and S configuration here the based on the CIP configuration. D and L is nothing but so lower electronegativity atom to higher electronegativity atom through the most oxidizable group. So if it is a clockwise direction, then it is D configuration. Then if it is anti-clockwise direction, then it is like a L configuration, anti-clockwise L configuration. We know that here. So low electronegativity to higher electronegativity location like this, okay, rotation like this through the most oxidizable group. In Fischer projection, the minimum criteria, most oxidizable group present over the top of the position. Okay, so here like it is assumed to be like a clock, 1, 2, 3, it is the clockwise direction, then it is called a D-glyceraldehyde. So same IT will show the another type of isomer due to the presence of a stereo. Like a stereogenic center, it's shown the stereoisomers. Now the rotation like this. So this is the L glyceraldehyde. So these are the compounds, D and L configurations. So D and L configuration. Now again, the simple molecule, our favorite molecule, glucose also, it's shown the different types of D and L configurations. So those are the number of carbons, are 6. Okay. Now let us go through the classification of carbohydrates. Now let us discuss the classification of carbohydrates. So here generally classification of carbohydrates mainly divided into food types based on their functionality, functional group, as well as like sweetness compounds, as well as a reducing property. The final one is the number of hydrolysis products, the number of hydrolysis products. So now here the first classification, so that is based on the functional group, it is classified two types. One is a polyhydroxyaldehyde compound, polyhydroxyketone compound, polyhydroxyaldehyde as well as polyhydroxyketone. The best example is glucose. The best example is fructose. Okay. After knowing these all the structures of the carbohydrate compound, you will easily classify which compound belongs to the which category. Okay. This is the polyhydroxyaldehyde as well as polyhydroxyketone. So this is the first classification. Now the second classification is nothing but based on the sweetness. So sweet compounds are called sugars, so non-sweet compounds are called non-sugars. Okay, here it is the sugars and the non-sugars. Sugars, best example is glucose as well as saccharides, monosaccharides. Now here the non-sugars, that is nothing but like cellulose, grassy moieties, like cellulose, starch, such type of compounds are sugars and non-sugars. Now the third classification, here it is the first classification, second classification, third classification, that is based on the reducing property. So compounds which use the Tollens and Fehling test, that is a reducing sugars, which cannot give those tests, then it is nothing but non-reducing sugars. Here it is classified two types, reducing and non-reducing sugars. Okay, so the reducing sugars, all the monosaccharides are reducing sugars. So monosaccharides means glucose, galactose, mannose, such type of compounds. Again, all the disaccharides are also reducing sugars, so that is except sucrose. Okay, sucrose is the non-reducing sugar. So I'll make the another video on that reducing and non-reducing sugar. Why? Because IIT JEE means as well as NEET and lower level APSET exams, competitive exams, they are asking about four four compounds. They are given in the four compounds. Among the four, which is the reducing agent, which is the reducing carbohydrate, which is the non-reducing carbohydrate. Based on that, they are given in this many type of questions, the direct question. That's why I'll make the another video on that reducing and non-reducing sugars. Okay, now we'll go through the fourth classification. Before going to the fourth classification, based on the hydrolysis of product, we will discuss the UPAC nomenclature of the compounds. UPAC nomenclature of the compounds. Okay, now here the IUPAC nomenclature of the carbohydrates. So here IUPAC aldehydes is nothing but aldose. Aldehydes are called as aldoles. Ketone compounds are called as ketones. So it is also another classification. But here, based on the nomenclature, that's why I'll give the nomenclature of the carbohydrates. So here the number of carbon atoms are there. So number of carbon atoms with aldehyde functionality as well as ketone functionality. So if number of carbon atoms are 3, then aldehyde functionality is there. Then it is called aldotriose. Based on that, number of carbon atoms are 3. So if it is 4, then it is called aldotetrose. So if it is 5, aldopentose. So if it is 6, aldohexose. Now here ketotriose, ketotetrose, ketopentose, ketohexose. These are the basic nomenclature of the our carbohydrates. So here it is also another classification. So that is the number of carbon atoms. It is classified aldotriose family, aldotetrose family, aldopentose family, aldohexose family. We have discussed in previous case that is nothing but basic compound of the carbohydrate. That is a CHO, CHOH, CH2OH. This is the glucose, glyceraldehyde. So glyceraldehyde is nothing but, so here 3 carbon atoms are there. This is the family of the aldotriose family. Why? Because here the functionality is a carbonyl compound. That's why it is aldotriose family. So we know that our favorite molecule, that is nothing but glucose moiety, HOH, COH, CH2OH. So this is the glucose. So here carbon atoms are 6 carbon atoms with aldehyde functionality. It is nothing but aldohexose family. Here 7 is there, aldoheptanose, aldo like a ketoheptanose type of the compounds are there. Okay, so these are the compounds examples. Here it is the aldohexose family. Now we know that fructose structure here, CH2OH, C double bond O, CH2OH, CH2OH. Here it is the fructose, 6 carbon atoms with ketone functionality. Then it is called ketohexose functionality, family. So this is an example of ketohexone family. Now let us go through the final classification based on the hydrolysis. So if there are the compounds are carbohydrates, we'll use the hydrolysis reaction. Okay, now we will discuss the final classification about the carbohydrate. It is very important classification. So now in previous case we will discuss the classifications based on the functionality, again based on the sweetness, based on the reducing property. The final one is IUPAC nomenclature. Okay, now in this case we will discuss the classification of the carbohydrates based on the if they are undergoes the hydrolysis reactions or not. Okay, if it can undergoes the hydrolysis reactions, let us assume if it gives the hydrolysis reactions, it gives how many number of monomeric units. Based on that, we will classify the carbohydrates into several parts. Okay, so the first one is if it gives the only one compound after the hydrolysis. So if any compounds which do not undergoes the hydrolysis, those type of compounds are called monosaccharides. So here we use the new term, that is nothing but saccharides. So the saccharides, it is a saccharum is the Latin word. Saccharum is nothing but a Latin word. That means here it is the sugars. So carbohydrates are the sugars. The sugars which cannot undergo the hydrolysis reaction. So those are called as monosaccharides. Again here it is furtherly classified into aldehydes and ketone functionality. Okay, so monosaccharides with aldehyde functionality, monosaccharides with ketone functionality. Okay, now however the second classification, that is nothing but oligosaccharides. So saccharum means, we know that saccharum means sugars, oligosugars. So now here in this case the number of carbon atoms, the number of units, here n is the not number of carbon atoms. In this case, after getting the hydrolysis reaction, it gives how many monomeric units. Okay, now here the number of monomeric units from n is equal to 2 to 10. If n is equal to 2 to 10, that means if any substance, let us assume here sucrose, so sucrose can undergo the hydrolysis reaction, which gives him 1 mole of glucose and another mole of fructose. Okay, So now here it gives the two types of like two monomeric units. Then it is class called as oligosaccharides. So the oligosaccharides can give the number 2 to 10 number of monomeric units, 10 number of monomeric units in their hydrolysis reaction. If it gives the 2, then it is called disaccharides. If it gives the 3, then it is called trisaccharides. If it is gives the 4, then it is called tetrasaccharides, like and so on. N is equal to 10. Until N is equal to 10, then it is decasaccharides. Okay, so this is the second classification. If N is equal to 2, then it is called di, 3, tri, 4, tetra, like that. So the final classification is polysaccharides. So that is nothing but a polymer of sugars, polymers of the sugars, then it is called as polysaccharides. The best examples are cellulose, okay, starch, glycogen, okay, all are the polymers of the glucose compounds, polymers of the glucose compound, which is from the glycerin, that is plants. Now starch, animal plants, animal starch, animal wastage of the starch, those are the polymers of the glucose compounds. Okay, now here these are the polysaccharides, monosaccharides, oligosaccharide. This is the final classification regarding to the all carbohydrate. Okay, now let us examine, let us discuss some of the examples regarding to the mono oligo polysaccharides. Now here monosaccharides, here the number of carbon atoms, here N is equal to number of units. Now that's why here M is equal to number of carbon atoms, number of carbon atoms. Now here N is equal to number of monomeric units after the hydrolysis reaction. Both are different, please be careful about those things. Okay, now here the number of carbon atoms, a number of carbon atoms of the monosaccharides, here N is equal to 3 to 7. It is the minimum criteria. Some of the textbooks they are given the 3 to 9 also, it doesn't matter. Okay, now here if number of carbon atoms 3 with aldehyde functionality, in previous case we will discuss the, that is nothing but glyceraldehyde. If it is 4, then it is nothing but erythrose or thiose. Again it gives the two types of isomers. Now again, if number of carbon atoms are 5, then it is like a ribose arabinose functionality. Number of carbon atoms are 6, then it is glucose functionality. So these are the aldehyde functionality. So with ketones it will give the fructose. Okay, so those are the best examples. Now in case of disaccharides, here it is sucrose, lactose, okay, maltose. Okay, so these are the disaccharides. Whenever sucrose will undergo the hydrolysis reaction, so it gives the one mole of glucose and another mole of fructose. Okay, one mole of glucose and another mole of fructose. Again, maltose will undergo the hydrolysis reaction, will give the 2 moles of glucose only, 2 moles of glucose. Now again, the lactose will undergo the hydrolysis reaction. It gives 1 mole of glucose and another mole of galactose. Okay, so glucose, galactose are the isomers, they are the isomers of the number of 6, that is aldohexose family, isomers of the aldohexose family. These are the hydrolysis reaction. So these three are the disaccharides. In these three, so here except sucrose, all are the reducing sugars. Sucrose is only non-reducing sugar. Okay, now here N is equal to 3, tri, that is nothing but raffinose. Okay, so here it undergoes the hydrolysis. It will use the three types of isomer, glucose, fructose, I think it is galactose. Here tetra, that is nothing but stachyose. Okay, here it gives the 4 number of monomeric units, that's why it is called as tetrasaccharide. Okay, finally we will finish the molecular formula of these compounds. Okay, now here the monosaccharides general formula of the glucose and fructose. Here the glucose formula is nothing but C6H12O6. Glucose and fructose formula is C6H12O6. This is the formula. Okay, now however the disaccharides of the same number of carbon atoms that is nothing but those compounds will give the hydrolysis reaction, then it gives the 2 monomeric units. Now here it gives the 2 monomeric units. Okay, so a substance will give the 2 monomeric units, that is the C6H12O6. Okay, plus C6H12O6. Okay, now here whenever it gives the two monomeric units, C6H12O6, then it undergoes the hydrolysis reaction. So that means here it gives the 2 moles of monomeric units in addition of the water molecule, that's why. So the compound A molecular weight, let us assume here C12, H24. So among the 24 moieties of hydrogens, here the water molecule is added. That means the starting compound doesn't have the one water molecule. That means two hydrogens are left out. So two hydrogens are removed, not the left out. Now here one oxygen is removed. 6, 6, 12. So among the 12, one oxygen is eliminated. Then we will get the O11. So this is the disaccharide formula. C12H22O11. In case of a trisaccharide, that means trisaccharide means it is multiplied with 3 times. C6H12O6, it is multiplied 3 times. C18H36O18. Okay, now in this case, trisaccharide means it requires 2 moles of hydrolysis moiety. So 2 moles of water moiety, that is nothing but 4 hydrogens, 2 oxygens are left out, removed. That means C18H32O16. So in case of tetramer, like a tetrasaccharides, here C24H48O24. In this case, 3 water molecules are removed. That means 6 hydrogens are left removed. C24H42O21. These are the like molecular formula of the compounds. So we know that in previous case we will discuss C6H10O5 n times. This is the like a representation of the polymer of the polysaccharides. Okay. That's all for this video. So in this session we will discuss very basic introduction of the carbohydrates as well as classification of the carbohydrates. In next session I'll discuss the like their structures and very simple tricks to remember these structures. Okay, thank you so much for watching.